Last week, I revisited the Terminator movie, and it got me thinking as an AI engineer. Have we finally reached the stage where we can create a visual detection and understanding system akin to what we see in the Terminator? This is exactly what we are going to build in the next minutes.
Trust me.
Four males, aged mid-20s to mid-50s. Threat assessment, no immediate threat detected. Situation appears to be a social interaction, possibly sports-related of a non-threatening nature. Conclusion, continue surveillance, minimal risk.
Before we delve in, let's discuss multimodal models, their strengths, and unveil the first GPT vision secret that most people don't know. Now, some of you may already be familiar with GPT vision's capabilities for analyzing PDFs and images, such as photographs from books, PDF documents containing charts, or even screenshots from websites. But did you know that you can use it to create recipes from a simple image of your fridge? Or have you ever considered snapping a photo of your menu and another of the empty bottles you've consumed, allowing GPT to understand the correlation and calculate the resulting price? And perhaps most crucially for our video, have you considered utilizing the GPT Vision API to recognize Harley-Davidson motorcycles or distinguish between attackers and civilians? Fear not, as I'll guide you step by step through utilizing GPT Vision to analyze both local and uploaded images.
Give them to me, now.
Let's first talk about how multimodal models work. For those unfamiliar, here's a brief primer. Traditional language models thrive on text alone. They ingest vast amounts of text data, transforming it into vectors. When prompted with new text, they predict subsequent words using this vector space. In contrast, a multimodal model goes beyond text, incorporating images and even videos. Behind the scenes, it works to tokenize various data types, merging them into a unified representation. This allows it to comprehend text, images, and videos, despite their differing formats. As already mentioned, if you provide it with an image of your fridge, it can identify the items inside and even generate a menu based on them. GPT-4V is capable of handling various types of images. And let's not forget its proficiency in recognizing text within images, even when the text is distorted or challenging to discern, as demonstrated in those examples. The part that I found most surprising is you can actually pass the complete Terminator screenplay, and the GPT-4V summarized the whole screenplay in one sentence. Okay, it's time to dive into the coding part. I'll build a new project from scratch so you can follow along with me. All right. Let's start our AI adventure at the coolest spot in town, aiforDevs.com. There's a beginner-friendly article waiting for us, teaching us how to wield GPT-4 vision like pros. Scrolling down, we find the magic code snippet that lets us chat with OpenAI. Time to grab that code and get this party started. But don't worry, I'll explain what's going on in just a sec. First things first, let's create a brand new project by making a folder. And because we like to keep it classy, we're using the command line and the super fancy mkdir command. Now, let's fire up Visual Studio Code, the superhero of text editors. Next up, we'll create a new file app.py. This file's gonna be our MVP. But wait, there's more. We're creating a special space just for our project called a virtual environment. Think of it as a VIP lounge for our code. Once our VIP lounge is ready, we'll invite the OpenAI library to join the party. We're ready to paste that magic code into app.py and watch the sparks fly. First, we're bringing in the OpenAI library from Python's vast collection of tools. This lets us connect directly to OpenAI's powerful AI models. Next, we create an instance of the OpenAI class, which is like setting up our direct line to the AI service. Now we're ready to ask the AI a question. We do this by using our client to call a function called chat.completions.create. This function is designed to handle conversational tasks. We specify that we're using the GPT-4 Turbo model. In our request, we describe what we need the AI to do. Here, we're asking, what's in this image? We also provide the URL of the image we want the AI to analyze. This image is hosted online and is accessible to the AI via its URL. After sending our request, the AI processes it and sends back a response. Finally, we print out the first choice from the AI's response. This choice contains the AI's answer to our question about what's in the image. First things first, we need a special key to talk to OpenAI's models. So head over to openai.com and log into your account. Once you're logged in, navigate to the API keys section. Give your key a memorable name, click create, and voila, you've got your secret key. Make sure to copy it. We'll need it in just a moment. Next, we're going to tell our computer how to remember this key so it knows we have permission to access OpenAI's models. Before we run our script, let's take a quick peek at what we're asking the AI about. Open your web browser and go to the image URL we have in our code. This should show you an image of a man, a woman, and a dog crossing a zebra crossing. Now back to where the action happens. Let's run the script and see what GPT tells us about the picture. The GPT model described the image as showing a joyful young man and woman holding hands and crossing the street at a crosswalk, accompanied by a small dog on a leash, set against an urban backdrop with parked cars, street lamps, and flower planters. It's impressive how well the model can interpret and describe scenes from images, right? All right, in our example, we've been using an image that's already online. But what if we have a picture on our computer that isn't on the internet? How do we get GPT to analyze something right from our local files? First, we need to turn our image into a format the AI understands, and we do this with a little magic called Base64 encoding. Here's a simple function we'll use. The encodeImage function uses the file location you give it to open your image in a special mode for reading files not made of text. It then turns the image into a text-like format that our AI can understand, using a process called Base64 encoding. When we have the image data converted to Base64 format, we use it to create a URL that the AI can process. This tells the AI that the data is an image in JPEG format and encoded in Base64, allowing it to directly read and analyze the image content. Let's drag in an image with some motorcycles. And naturally, we'll need to update the image name accordingly. Let's give it a try and see how it handles our low-resolution image of the red motorcycle from the Terminator movie. Okay, that's quite a thorough analysis. All right, let's simplify the prompt so GPT keeps the response brief. For this, we can simply tweak the text in our prompt directly. We just add the note to the existing prompt, keep it short, and we'll try it again. In just 2 minutes, you'll also learn how to further refine the response using few short prompts.
The image shows two people on a Harley-Davidson motorcycle, partially blurred, against a reddish background.
Actually, this doesn't quite capture the Terminator vibe yet, but we'll revisit that soon. First, I want to show you how to process multiple images at once, because this technique will be crucial when we start analyzing videos later on. Let's streamline the process by duplicating the image URL message and adjusting the image names accordingly. For our scenario, we aim to include two screenshots from the movie, one depicting the iconic red vision of the bikers, and another featuring a motorcycle scene. After duplicating, we need to update the file paths accordingly to ensure proper referencing. Let's remember, we're only adding two images for simplicity's sake, but this concept can easily scale up to more complex programs, like ones analyzing images from a webcam. And we change the prompt. What is the connection between the pictures? We drag in the second picture, a beautiful biker in red. We'll give it a try, and I'm curious about the connection between these pictures. Obviously, they're from the same movie, with poor resolution, and feature predominantly red and white colors. All right, let's ask GPT to keep it short, as that's too much for a 10-minute video. We run it again, and its response is that both pictures feature a stylized red visual overlay, often accompanied by technical data and analysis. It thinks the connection is well recognized. All right, but how can we achieve the distinctive style and tone characteristic of Terminator? We can use a method called few-shot prompts. This technique enables our AI to quickly adapt and learn from a minimal amount of data. Our messages list is structured to have two primary roles, the system and the user. The system role is designed to process and respond based on predefined examples, which guide the AI in understanding and generating the desired output. Here's how it works. We begin by inputting specific examples into our system. Each example consists of a prompt and a corresponding AI-generated response. For instance, when presented with an image of an urban setting, the system might analyze and describe potential threats or points of interest based on its training. Therefore, we no longer need the hint in the user prompt. Let's keep it simple and remove it. Let's also remove the second image because we don't need it for this example. Let's try it out. Great, our AI now not only analyzes but also communicates like the real Terminator. This achievement isn't just a technical milestone, it's incredibly cool. The final step in bringing our AI to life involves using ElevenLabs, a cutting-edge voice synthesis platform. ElevenLabs specializes in generating highly realistic and expressive voice clones. With its advanced technology, it's possible to replicate existing voices with remarkable accuracy. The pasted code is very similar to the getting started example from ElevenLabs. I just added a speak method so that we can call it from our app.py. Here, we import the method and then call it with the messages content from GPT Vision. Keep in mind that this is already the version that sounds like the Terminator. All right, to close the loop, we will use an image from the beginning of the video showing a gang doing some outdoor exercises. Let's adjust the file name and then give it a try. Let's listen to the newly created MP3 sound file.
Observation confirms the presence of four individuals engaging in what appears to be a friendly interaction in an urban environment with a textured brick wall and metal structure, suggesting a setting commonly used for recreational or training purposes. No immediate threats detected. Proceeding with routine surveillance protocols.
I hope you enjoyed this video. You can find more entertaining AI videos at aifordevs.com.